Houston tourism bounces back. Considering a trip to Houston this fall? Go for it. The city may be in hurricane recovery mode, but it's definitely open for business. Though many Houstonians are still piecing their lives back together, the city's downtown area was mainly spared from the wrath of Hurricane Harvey. Both airports are fully operational and reachable via the normal roads, as are all metro rail and most local bus routes. The vast majority of hotels, 98% of Hotel and Lodging Association of Greater Houston members, more than 350 at last count, have reopened, as have most major attractions and restaurants near downtown, the Heights, the Galleria, and the other central districts. The city may be bouncing back, but it won't heal overnight, and its residents will need long-term support. The best way to assist Houston in its recovery is by coming to visit, the city's tourism office says. Keep your planned travel, keep your scheduled meetings, and keep coming back. Volunteer opportunities abound, from food banks to cleanup crews. There's a serious need for extra hands, but if you can't get there in person, the Greater Houston Community Foundation's Hurricane Harvey Relief Fund, the Texas Diaper Bank, the Houston Humane Society, and plenty of other worthy organizations are accepting donations. On the ground, here's where things stand for three major sectors of the tourism industry. Dining. A whole lot of the 12,000-plus restaurants in the greater Houston area were affected by the storm. Most were closed for at least 3 or 4 days in the immediate aftermath, and supply chain issues persisted for a week to 10 days, but the majority are now back up and running, according to Jonathan Horowitz, CEO of Legacy Restaurants and president of the Greater Houston Restaurant Association. Sports. Other than a few games that had to be moved to different locations or forfeited entirely, Houston's professional and college-level sports teams have returned to their regular schedules, and there shouldn't be any additional impact over the course of the next few months. Arts. Some of the city's marquee performing arts venues were hit hard by the flooding. After the Wortham Theater Center was damaged extensively, companies such as the Houston Ballet and the Houston Grand Opera had to reschedule performances and scramble to find new homes for their new seasons, as did plays slated for runs at the Alley Theater Center. The Health Museum is offering one free admission for every 4 non-perishable food items to donate to the Houston Food Bank. Asia Society Texas Center is promoting food donations and from September 23 to December 31, offering complimentary entrance to their Wondrous Worlds exhibition. The Museum of Fine Arts, Houston is offering $5 tickets to paint the Revolution, Mexican Modernism 1910 to 1950 through October 1, and has been providing free gallery and studio experiences to hundreds of his elementary students. The Children's Museum of Houston is collecting school supplies and HIST uniforms while offering free admission to families in transition from shelters. Rothko Chapel is open and free 365 days a year and providing special programs every Wednesday from 12 to 1 p.m. through the end of October to support healing as we individually and collectively discover new ways to work and serve together in the days ahead.